boundaries of the expectations. This is a terrific fight.
You've got to remember the amateur experience these guys have got. They're more experienced than most professionals in this country, with, as Troy said, like 170 amateur fights between them. That's a hell of a lot of experiences. When you look at guys like great amateurs like Costa Zou, 300 amateur fights, and you know, can win a world title in 20 professional fights or less. That's what it's all about. That amateur experience is also important at top level.
And you've got to say, look, these guys have had so many amateur fights, I'm on no doubt. In the amateurs, they're four guys who've gone on to win world titles as professionals.
A big one underneath, right? Come on.
You know, they've fought very, very good fighters on their way up.
Undoubtedly, all around the world too. Michael Katsidis has had a couple of warnings now for hitting low. I just hope he doesn't end up losing himself a point for that.
He doesn't need that. But, I mean, I think he's got enough of a buffer at the moment to still stay in front with a point deduction.
Mate, I tell you, this Sheffro's dangerous. He's a dangerous puncher.
Well, look, as I can see, Sheffro cannot win this fight on points. You know, Katsidis just outworking his man, just throwing too many punches. Katsidis has got to be careful because there is that one shot. It could be lights out.
Well, the work rate's winning it for Katsidis. You know, the volleys of punches he's thrown from both hands, but, oh, there's good countering punches from Sheffro at any time when he's under pressure. He's likely to come out with a bomb, as he did against the ropes a couple of times. I knew this was going to be a ripper of a fight.
Yeah, when you've got so much experience coming into the ring, bro, you know, first couple of rounds are a bit slow to get started, but once they've got started, you know, they've found their range. And the war is on.
He's tying too, Johnny. Don't worry about that.
Quiet, Johnny.
He's tying too.
You weigh in for your defense. You weigh in for your defense. Cut your way in. You're going to defend. You do some damage.
Oh, my God.
No.
This boy's taking a little bit of a breather in this round. As I said, oh, they both come out with beautiful right hand left hook combination from Katsidis.
Punch for punch, they're both landing big punches, I tell you.
Seconds remaining, round five of a scheduled 8-rounder. It's Olympians from the Sydney Games. Putting on quite a show here. A big-time boxing from the Whitlam Centre. And still to come, Anthony Mundine and Darren O'Barr, our feature event. As Katsidis again finds the target with the right hand.
Marginally low with that shot. Closer round, but I think Katsidis' work rate might be edging.
Yeah, still Katsidis just edging this round.
Top one there. Needs to compose himself, Michael Katsidis, coming up to the end of round five.
Look, I'm sure after that fourth round, there's a little bit of energy being expelled. It's a very, very hard, tough round.
Well,
and this fifth round obviously has to be a bit of a breather round. Get some energy back.
Three rounds to go for the lightweights. Then we'll clear the decks for our feature event. And Anthony Mundine and Darren O'Barr aren't too far away. And we're happy to see Darren O'Barr in the frame then. He's been largely anonymous during the build-up to this fight. But he is ready to go here from the Whitlam Centre at Liverpool. And Anthony Mundine in the red and white trunks for this fight. Looking to maintain his impressive record. Darren O'Barr, the body snatcher, 19-3 is his record. And at least one of those defeats was a very disputed decision for the OPBF title. Fought overseas. Of course, one of his other losses came in the fight for the WBA middleweight title against Julio Cesar Green, Madison Square Garden, back in February 1999. Well, what a clash we have going here at center ring at the moment, the lightweight division. Coming up to round six of a scheduled 8-rounder, Michael Katsidis, former Australian lightweight champion in the white trunks, and Johan Sheffro, who represented Ethiopia at the Sydney Olympics. He is in the blue, 50-46 for Troy Waters at the moment. I have 50-48 in favour of Katsidis so far.
Oh, good right hand from Katsidis.
Beautiful right hand. Sneaky punch.
Good punching back there from Sheffro.
Good basic skills from Sheffro. Now just, there's a nice sneaky right hand once again.
He really hasn't got going so far, Sheffro, but maybe he is going to do so here in round six.
He's trying to confuse Katsidis with all this flashy stuff, but
Look, I'm sure Kinsey's just seen it all before.
Doesn't help if you're not throwing and landing punches.
Chevreau again on the ropes. Kinsey's looking for an opening. Nice. Again, the work rate is impressive.
Yep. Superbly conditioned boy, Michael Kinsey. His second pro fight, he went 12 rounds against very seasoned James Swan to win the Australian lightweight title. So he knows what it's like to go the distance. He's got a couple more rounds to go here. He'll do the distance easy.
Yeah.
He's pretty well ahead on points. Chevreau looking pretty good this round for Kinsey's.
Chevreau's best round is throwing more punches.
Oh, man.
Beautiful right hand.
I'll tell you what, they're two tough boys. These. Yeah. They can both take a shot. Good work from Katsidis.
It's the body shots that are hurting Chevreau.
Oh, lovely uppercut from Michael Katsidis.
Both boys coming back.
I like this Katsidis, man. He's got a big heart. He can take a shot.
Oh, he's got a good chin.
He mixes them up, you know, underneath, over the top. Great body puncher. Power in both hands. Got an enormous future. And against a very seasoned opponent.
Well, that's just it. I was just about to say, Barry, he's not fighting a mug out there. He's fighting a well-experienced, you know.
For sure, mate.
Highly talented kid.
I can see he's stalking his opponent coming forward.
Oh, there's a nice
forward.
Right hand from Chevreau. Back at Cedis, keeps the pressure on and keeps working. Nice right hand.
Oh, look, punches from
I like what this kid's doing. He just doesn't stop working.
No, even when he cops a couple of hard ones, mate, he just keeps coming back.
Here's Chevreau holding on.
You know what, Case too, he's and Troy, he's such a crowd pleaser, Katsidis. He's got a great future. The Aussie public are going to love him as he goes up his career. Or hit with a couple of bombs there. Walks back in. Yeah, Chevreau looking for a bomb.
Yeah, Chevreau's turned south. Beautiful left hand.
Katsidis hit with a bomb but didn't bat an eyelid.
That was a beautiful left hand.
There again, Chevreau's southpaw.
Yeah, having a little bit more success in the southpaw style.
We saw Chevreau do that against Quinton Donoghue very early in the fight, and it was most impressive. He's waited till round number six to start switching in this one. That was his best round so far.
Good water, Simon. Just counting you, mate. Okay. Slow your breathing down, Mick. Breathe in nice and deep.
You're jabbing, he's carrying everything. You're better when you go.
Listen,
second.
This bloke don't want to go on, fellas. He hadn't sat in.
See that? He does not want to be there.
He wanted to pull then and they pushed him on further.
Mate, wear the first couple of the gloves.
Count back quick.
Don't wear it. Then wait.
Simon, dip that.
Let's look at the action from round number six. Katsidis had Chevreau pinned on top of our commentary position, unloading some big shots. Then Chevreau found the target himself. And at the moment in the blue corner, yeah, there's some doubt about Johan Chevreau wanting to continue. Paul Gretsch and George Reno have talked him into it.
He wasn't keen to come out at all, this lad.
No.
That's a bad sign.
Yeah, I was just going to say, not a good sign.
I wonder if Michael Katsidis saw that. If he did, his confidence will be extremely high.
If he saw this, he'll jump on his man.
Well, Brendan Smith, who was seconding for Petros, pointed that out.
Come on.
Told him that Chevreau didn't want to continue.
Yeah, well, that's you know, very good for Michael Katsidis. It gives him an enormous boost in confidence. He's up on top. He's got Chevreau in trouble. He's looking for the knockout here.
Chevreau looking top.